My son and I have made Pinewood Derby cars that have won scout and parent races year after year in our pack. In this video, I'll show you, step by step, how to make a car like ours that can win your pack's Pinewood Derby race. And I'll show you how to do this using only basic tools. Now, the internet is full of tips on how to make a fast Pinewood Derby car, but the tips aren't all equally good. Our cars use the most effective and worthwhile tips that we have found.
How do we do
These tips were explained in our previous video, which is linked below.
We're gonna show you how.
For this video, I've divided our process for making a winning car into 10 steps. I'll take you through these steps using a real example. Before we start building, we need to make some decisions about the car's design. First, we'll follow all the official Scout rules that come with the car kit. In addition, we'll follow our PAC's rules, which say you can only use what comes in the official car kit, and you cannot modify the wheels except for light sanding. We'll pick a simple, flat car shape, which is the easiest to make and uses only basic tools. Although simple, this car can win the race. I'll give you some ideas for fancier designs at the end. We'll follow our previous video by moving the wheels from their standard positions to the ends of the car. This will require drilling our own holes for the axles instead of using the axle slots provided in the block of wood. We'll make the car so its balance point is 3/4 to 1 inch in front of the back wheel. This is by far the most important part of the design. Now, it turns out that to meet these requirements, the body of the car can't be much taller than about 3/8 of an inch. If the car is taller, the front would have more wood and be heavier, moving the balance point forward. We would need to add more counterweights to get the balance point back to where we want it. But if we did that, the car would weigh more than the 5-ounce limit. So we'll keep the height at 3/8 of an inch. Okay, let's start building. The next step is to mark the location of all the holes you need to drill. The axle holes are located 5/8 of an inch from each end and 1/8 of an inch above the bottom, except for the left front axle hole, which is 3/16 of an inch above the bottom. On the bottom of the block, there are 4 holes over the axles for gluing them in place. Turn the block over because you won't be using the pre-cut axle slots. Draw a line across the bottom of the block 5/8 of an inch from each end. Along the axle lines, mark the glue holes 1/4 of an inch from each side of the block. Use an awl to make an indentation for the glue holes. This helps to keep the drill bit from shifting when you drill the hole. On the side of the block, mark the car's shape. For our simple car, it's just flat on the top. It's important to drill the holes perfectly straight, so we recommend using a drilling guide like this one. The drilling guide comes with a drill bit that is exactly the right size for the nails that come with the Pinewood Derby kit. The drilling guide has a hole for drilling regular axle holes, and another hole for drilling one axle hole that is higher than the rest. To use the drilling guide, position it over the axle line, insert the drill bit, and drill a hole that is 3/4 of an inch deep. Use the raised hole to drill the left front axle hole. On the bottom of the block, drill the 4 glue holes. Be careful and only drill deep enough to reach the axle holes. In our workshop, we drill all holes with the drill press. It's a little more accurate and we can position the holes exactly where we want. But the drilling guide also seems to do a pretty good job, and we've seen races won by cars made with one. The next step is to cut the car's shape. You can do it with a handsaw. If you do, mark the car's shape on both sides of the block and cut slowly to follow the marks on both sides of the car. For our simple shape, it's not hard to do. In our workshop, we cut the car's shape with a bandsaw. For shapes that have curves, a bandsaw is much easier than using a handsaw. Some Cub Scout packs, like ours, have their own bandsaws to help with car shaping. For safety, these machines must be operated by adult leaners only. Smooth the car's shape with 100 or 150 grit sandpaper. Be patient, a good sanding job takes some time. In our workshop, we use a stationary belt sander to smooth out the top of the car. You can add a small slant to the front of the car so the front looks different from the back. Some Cub Scout packs, like ours, also have their own belt sanders to help with car shaping. For safety, these machines must be operated by adult leaders only. planning the car's weight is the most important step. Most Pinewood Derby cars weigh much less than the 5-ounce limit, but to have the fastest car, you should use all 5 ounces that are allowed. This means weights must be added to the car. The most common weights for Pinewood Derby cars are made from steel, but they aren't heavy enough. Almost 2 packages of steel weights would be needed, and there isn't enough room on the car for that many. Instead, use tungsten weights, which are much heavier. They are almost twice as heavy as lead. The main disadvantage is that tungsten weights cost more than steel or lead weights. Whatever weights you use, start by weighing all the car parts. Then add enough weights to get as close to 5 ounces without going over. If your weights don't make exactly 5 ounces, find smaller objects to adjust the weight. Prop up a ruler and place the car on the ruler's edge to determine the balance point. When doing this, put the axle nails into the axle holes just far enough to hold the wheels temporarily. Move the weights until the balance point is 3/4 to 1 inch in front of the rear axle. You may need a little tape to hold the weights temporarily while you're doing this. When you have the right balance point, mark the location of the weights. Prepare for painting by sanding all surfaces with 220 grit or finer sandpaper. Because we don't go for looks, we usually don't paint the car. Instead, we place the car body on a scrap wood block and spray on a clear finish. After all, this is the Pinewood Derby, and a clear finish shows off the pine wood. We spray with semi-gloss or gloss lacquer, 4 to 5 coats on the top and sides, and 2 coats on the bottom. Lacquer dries very fast between coats, and it provides a hard surface for the wheels to spin against, reducing friction. If you want to paint your car, cover the area around the axle holes with painter's tape. Otherwise, paint around the holes can rub on the wheels and slow them down. After painting, remove the painter's tape and spray with lacquer. The axle nails and wheels may have imperfections. If you look closely at each nail, there are small burrs underneath the nail head. Using a power drill as a holder, file off the burrs using a small triangular file. Do not turn on the power drill. File only as much as needed to remove the burr without filing the rest of the nail. Check each wheel. The bore should be smooth and shiny inside. Carefully shave off any extra plastic at the wheel edge that was left over from molding the plastic. Be very careful not to dig into the main edge of the wheel. Glue the weights on the car securely. A hot glue gun is a common way to attach things to Pinewood Derby cars, but hot glued pieces sometimes fall off the car during the race. 2-part, 5-minute epoxy is better for gluing on the weights. It's also great for many household repairs, so I'll take a minute to show you how to use it, in case you've never done it. It's best to buy epoxy in separate tubes rather than a 2-part syringe. The syringe is hard to use and messy for mixing small amounts. To mix the epoxy, use index cards and flat toothpicks. Round toothpicks don't work as well. Squeeze an equal bead of each part of the epoxy on an index card. Mix thoroughly with a toothpick. Use toothpicks to apply just the right amount of epoxy. Mix more if needed. Use graphite lubricant to prepare the wheels. Put some graphite on a clean cloth and rub the graphite on the wheel treads. Also rub graphite on the inside of the wheel and around each axle hole of the car. Look at the axle nails and put them in order of smoothness. Pick the 2 smoothest ones for the rear because they will carry most of the car's weight. Pick the worst one for the raised left front wheel. The remaining nail will be the steering axle. Each nail has ridges on the shaft. When using them for axles, make sure these ridges are facing up, so they rub less inside the wheel's hub. Put the steering axle into a wheel and make a mark on the axle just outside the wheel hub. This mark shows what part of the axle is outside the wheel. Place the steering axle in a vise with the ridges facing toward one side of the vise. Make sure the vise only grips the part of the nail that will not be inside the wheel. Mark the nail's head with a permanent marker, with the mark showing the direction of the ridges. Bend the axle slightly in the direction of the mark by holding a thin block of wood against the nail and pushing the wood block by hand or tapping it lightly with a hammer. Only tap lightly a couple times. The nail only has to be bent very slightly, about 1 degree. This axle will be used to adjust the direction in which the car rolls. Put each nail into a wheel and carefully press the nail into the correct axle hole with the ridges facing up. Leave 1/32 of an inch gap between the inner wheel hub and the side of the car. To get just the right wheel gap, make a spacer out of 4 index cards taped together or a single layer from the cardboard box that came with the Pinewood Derby car kit. Cut a small slot in the card 1/8 of an inch wide and 1/4 of an inch deep. Put the spacer slot over each axle and push the nail head until the inner wheel hub is up against the spacer. With all wheels installed, the left front wheel is raised off the track, and the right front wheel, which has a slightly bent axle, touches the track. This slightly bent axle allows us to adjust the car so it rolls perfectly straight. The usual method for checking if the car rolls straight is to roll it down a board, but there's a big problem with this method. It is hard to aim the car perfectly straight down the middle of the board. It's too easy to aim the car slightly left or slightly right. Our son came up with a better solution. Use his toy ramp, which has sides on it. Instead of checking if a car rolls straight down the middle, check to see if it rolls straight down each side. If the car drifts to one side, turn the steering axle slightly with the pliers, maybe an eighth of a turn, until the car runs straight down both sides of the ramp. When adjusting the steering axle, be very gentle and don't dent the nail head. You could even cover the pliers with tape. If you don't have a ramp, you can make something similar with a board or shelf, and some wood strips taped on each side. When all the axles are in their final positions, dab a small amount of epoxy in the glue holes on the bottom of the car to lock the axle positions. Apply plenty of graphite between each nail head and wheel, and between each wheel and the side of the car. Spin each wheel by hand to make sure graphite goes inside the wheel bore. Add more graphite if necessary. Well, there you have it, a simple car with all the tips that we have used to win our PAC's Pinewood Derby races. The car's most important feature is a balance point that is 3/4 to 1 inch in front of the rear wheels. With this type of tar design, the front and back look similar, so we add an arrow to show which way the car runs. Now that we've shown you our 10-step guide, here are some additional hints, details, and suggestions. If you want to keep things simple, you can skip this part. When using a drilling guide, you should be successful by following the instructions that come with it. But if you want the holes positioned exactly as we do, you may need to make adjustments, such as shimming with pieces of index card. If your PAC's rules require you to use the axle slots, it's a good idea to drill them out with the special axle drill bit. Otherwise, it's very easy to damage the slots when pushing in the axles. If you must use the axle slots, spread some epoxy or other adhesive over the nails to hold them in. Otherwise, it's easy for the axles to fall out during the race. If you want to make a car shape that is not flat, but keep the balance point in the back, you need to do something to make the car's front lighter. One method is to hollow out the car. This works well, but it requires additional tools and woodworking skills. A much easier method is to make the car skinnier by cutting away the sides. A car will look better if you hide the weights underneath, but this requires additional tools and skills, and it won't make a difference in speed. Avoid car designs that are shorter than full length. Shorter cars do not allow weight to be as far back as possible. If your car has a pointed front, make sure there is still a small flat part to rest against the racetrack's starting pin. If you want to make your car even faster, we recommend polishing the axles. This requires a drill press to do well. Watch out for a future video showing how we do it. Polishing the axles makes a noticeable difference, but the difference is relatively small. We have won races without doing it. Instead of having the wheels square to the track, some builders tilt the wheels. Tilted wheels decrease friction in some ways, but could also increase it in other ways, so we've never tried it. If you want to try tilted wheels, the drilling guide has holes that allow you to drill tilted axles. I can't stress enough the importance of weight position. Here's a graph for some cars we have made. It shows that as the balance point moves closer to the back of the car, the race time goes down, meaning a faster car. Even a quarter inch can make a difference. You can learn a lot by Googling for Pinewood Derby tips, but we learned the old-fashioned way. We checked out this book from our public library. It covers nearly all the tips we use and much more. Well, that's a wrap. I hope this video helps you build a winning car. Let us know in the comments below. We had a lot of fun learning how to make Pinewood Derby cars, and hope you will too.